Greetings, welcome back to the party. Let's continue our journey again. I'm going to move my focus to another star light in the sky. You once again find yourself under the quiet moods of moonlight alcove. Here you can await the time until the stars rain to shine through you again. We have returned to a place of rest. Please make yourselves comfortable as much as you can. We are at the mercy of the stars, but I expect they all shall shine bright again in time. As for me, I shall return by then for the rest of I must do. There, from atop the sacred mountain, you gaze down into the abyss, that's the downside. You wonder when the stars shall align themselves once more. There, upon the sacred mountain, you and your companions once more await the night the stars begin to shine again. The plan of which we are all a part is set in motion. The Commonwealth, a nation that stood almost for 1,000 years, is in turmoil. If your companions return their free regulation rights, what sort of place will they be coming back to? Anyone's path. One evening, amid a downpour with no interest whatsoever irrelevantly, Wolfhead requests everybody to convene. You understand he has an announcement of some sort. Soon, everyone is assembled and Wolfhead regards the group. Everyone, there is an aspect of our plan which I haven't talked about with you at length. Look around at your companions. What do you see in them? There is a question hanging a moment in the air. I'll tell you what I see in all of you, in all of us. I see in all of us a living vision of the eight scribes themselves. Each one among them hailing from different tribes which later formed a commonwealth. My observation does not come from pompousness, I think. Rather, I believe the scribes themselves desire, or shall I say desire, such a course. Together, they created all this ceremony of which we are now a part. Exiles liberated through their rights went on to found the Commonwealth based on their values and their teachings. Thus, an instrumental aspect of our plan is to embody the spirit and the culture on which the Commonwealth arose so many centuries ago. That way, when we are all united on the other side in solidarity, the people all shall see that we reflect the values they cherish in their hearts, not merely our own. Anyway, we are still missing one key representative in half of Molten Militia, and I happen to know a certain bog dweller who I think shall fit the part most splendidly indeed. Motions seem to approach. A certain bold dweller slid us forward. You recognize his trickery. It is my pleasure to introduce to you a dear old friend of mine, who I believe you've met. Welcome to the Nightwings, Bertrude. The bold dweller called Big Bertrude uttered something guttural by way of greeting. We understand that you require further aid from us. Yes, Lee Bertrude, there has come. Bertrude here is far and away the most accomplished alchemist whom I have ever met. You'll soon find that she knows much about the rites as well. Bertrude looks you and your fellow exiles, each in turn, defending you. Everyone is silent as Bertrude searches their expression. Then tremble, small ones, and hold well thy tongues, lest we remove them. She takes her leave without a word. This excuse Bertrude's blunt manner. I guarantee you she shall more than make up for it. Everyone disperses. It seems now that the rest of the nightmares are complete. Bertrude joined the group, who sends her powerful presence.
goddess Thas.
No, then, my girl. Perhaps you notice that the stars are bright once more up there behind those tamarinds. Meaning it is time that we get back to business. Indeed, once more celestials shine bright within the cold and stormy sky. It stirs himself away the will of the Nightwings. Yes, this is right to understand that we shall soon confront Saint Rouge and the Pyre Herds once more. Then this is to be a most exciting time. This night's one temporary officer. Imagine, if you will, a room of our best ladies chasing bravery. It's like your man then recounts his tale of Saint Rouge's past and how it is that they wound up together in the downside. Saint Rouge, a rare knight of the Sea Dominion and former ally of Sir Gilman. He likes the sort of courage for which his kind is known, but somehow leaves the player hearts anyway. Some weren't born under Sea Dominion's waters, so life meet on a dry land. The Commonwealth recognized their Chitara's traditions and soon put their cues. Sir Bulut was just another bit of frontline fodder in the world of the hiding remnants, yet time and time again he distinguished himself for one simple reason. He would not die. His usual instinct for self-preservation kept him safe in many battles, and over time, he was repeatedly promoted for lack of any real competition. Then, in the Battle of the Spiral Sanctum, when retreat certainly was not an option, Cerberus retreated anyway. This was a breaking point, and he at last was sentenced into exile. On the downside, the salt water, where he made contact with Sir Gilman and other members of his kind. They all salutated him as their superior. The other knights had little choice but to respect his man. As the Pyre Hearts, they conducted their rites in the name of the great hero, the ardent empress, while adhering to their strict code. This knight might not have failed quite so miserably at the end, at the Princess Power Sanctum. But this is a tiny remnant of doing in disarray after Sir Gilman left. Perhaps by confronting his former commander, this knight's only honor may be regained in part. For now, however, this knight must beg you of me. He said goodnight to Sir Gilman in time. There's no time to make side preparations now, though in the morning he will press on once again. Rites of Flame. With its blackened nails, do I hereby inscribe the Rites of Flame. The bylaws shall be written here in full. We, the eight, decree the rites attest of one's true worth in body, mind, and spirit. Now, until the stars abandon us, we shall be binding law within the downside. Those deemed worth in the rites are to regain their freedom from the downside and return from whence they came. Exiles shall conduct the rites as one of nine triumvirates and look toward the stars for guidance on their path. Exiles shall bear this book as status. Essential structure. The essential structure of the rites shall be as follows. Where chosen by the stars within the dark of night shall two triumvirates stand in opposition, far enough afield beside the consecrated pyre symbolizing the result. In each triumvirate, the three shall act as one, demonstrate their trust in one another, not just in themselves. Triumvirates shall endeavor to extinguish the pyre of the adversary, whose flames are only to be staunched through a celestial orb descended from the stars. Whosoever pyre remains burning shall prevail, the triumvirates are to disperse. Retrospect. unusual etched cards depicting the greater titans' political process and enchantments. Searching the stars. We, the Eight, have seen the turning of the stars from now until the ending of our age. Heed their guidance and ours. The stars take many secret turns. The rites command at their behest upon celestial landmarks where the downsized greater titans fell before the heavens. Bearing this book bestowed on you, Triumvirate, you, the reader, shall perceive under which star you are to congregate. Follow with where they lead, as your adversaries show. If either of you fails to appear, then neither of you walks the path. Whether you prevail or you fail, from that point the star shall guide you on. You find Big Bertrand looking about the black wagon in a disapproving way. He fixes her gaze on you. Her expression does not change. You're such a clatter. How did this sweet incense we looked upon at last? Unsightly. We remember the year from our boat in flying hands. Then there must be the reeking one to whom Sandal would refer. She moves in close, studying you. You recall that the mere tap on the popcorn of the salting bulbs can induce paralysis or worse. There are tools such as they can extract me from that pen. It was a feat we wish to witness for ourselves. My flesh has seen but the smallest fraction of the years which also stood, and yet we are expected to believe that Bob has understood the Book of Rites. Then she backs away for someone else has joined you. Hail, Bertrude, madame. Is everything to your liking at this time? Or is there something more which you require? We have your navy to locate a supply of rotul and a lizard extract among thy belongings. Other than that, we shall lodge no complaint at present. It is possible that Wolfert has a small supply among his possession here. If you would care to accompany me, we may yet procure some. That would be a great relief. And after you, madame. As they depart your thing, you see Don Mistro nod his head away. You rise early that morning, though Bertrude is already awake, she calls at you. Good morning, reader, Bertrude. I trust your stay has been not too uncomfortable. Nay, Sandalwood. The comforts of this place are not for us. Fly us forth from here to lower ground. Let us get on with all of this. The reader here shall do so once the group is ready. I thank you for your patience. The hidden cave door is nigh impossible to find on full day. Here it is, below us. Protected even now by the enchantment of the loose glowing hand of mine. I understand the river named for him is rather famous in the commonwealth. The mouth of that river's glowing opens wide. Not very far from here. It was there that Limbus Isaac was defeated, turning the region large and livable, at least for certain dungeons, although of course, not everyone believes this. Your adversaries that are your heart must be waiting to find the raider even now. Good fortune in your right against the leader. Wilfred is poring over a copy of a book right as you approach. He looks up at you and smiles. The road to freedom, written in a book that hardly anyone exists, and fewer still can read and comprehend. Sometimes I marvel how absurd all of this is, my brother. Tell me something, though. I spent so much time considering the book, but know so few with whom I could discuss it in much detail. You've had some time to turn through it by now, so what do you think? Worth all the fuss? Fascinating. You told the wolf that the book has fascinated you and that you have never seen anything quite like it. And slowly as you describe the experience of it, I share the sentiment. To have it in our possession, a genuine artifact from a forgotten time. How much of it is exactly true, and how much of it is describes the retelling of events? I found it endlessly fascinating to consider, I must admit. He puts away his copy of the book with care. It is amazing that these volumes have survived for all this time, I think. Whatever they are made of has withstood the revision effects of time quite well, and the ideas that contain them. They remain rather provocative as well, to think that the Commonwealth disables of the existence of this book despite official recognition of its scribes. Although, the reasons why are in there, we can claim. How fascinating that its secrets have been kept all this time. Anyway, you have to excuse me for my extracurricular interest in its teachings. I used to teach a version of its history. You have access to the real thing has brought me some small pleasure. Let us be certain to preserve these volumes for whomever shall be next to use them. He turns his attention to the matters and bids you a good afternoon. You spend a quiet afternoon in the rays of bamboo cinderwood, surveying the area with some of your companions. How's it looking, bro? Isn't it quiet and peaceful in the way, I feel? The investigation leads nothing of note. The three of you return to the waiting for the remainder of the day, where you should have time to pursue your vacations. You will teach me more about the rites? You and Faye compare thoughts on how each of your fellows is can contribute to prevailing in the rites, and in which groups of three they may begin achieve their very best. Each of us, we have a part to play, I think. Like how they scribe into one another. Yes, come on, but whatever happened to that member of the wings, you know, the one I guess she's gonna keep me, maybe, there is a boat, she's still around, play the chance, because, well, anyways. Thank you for stopping by, guys! The Glade of Blue. Never have I witnessed an affront to nature Mine and everyone's, quite like the poisoned witch of Olympus, Ares like the root titan in the suffocating influence. I shall leave it to the boastful underking to tell more of Arizek's vanquishing, whilst I may tell you something of the blade that he protected, which became my own, for my own genealogy now occupies the soil there and strives forevermore to prevent Arizek from taking it again. The brambles of the glade are constantly encroaching on themselves and falling once again to dust. This miraculous cycle, reflected in the starlight piercing through the canopy, needs to be witnessed whenever the stars invite an audience. Loki is counting a good supply of soul when he sees your approach. He rushes right up to your surface custom. Hey sister, I will just see a little bit bigger from the slug nugget next time we get. Been running some numbers here, and by my count, we've made all 501 with by 392 gold so far, if you can believe that. It's probably doing pretty well these days, just thanks to us. But I think we got a decent arrangement going. All you saw ain't gonna do us any good down here, and one small merchandise can help us a great get ahead. Those talismans are weird, right? But they seem to work. Especially if you heap some of that stardust stuff into them, right? Say, you don't think it's cheating using that stuff, do you, sister? It does not give you the opportunity to answer. No, anyway, 29, we go way back, alright, like you don't even know. You know, we technically, we knew each other even back before I ended up down here. He was one of my importers, so to speak. Yeah, he and I, we had a good thing going for a while. Then all sorts of junk downriver to him, and back in the Commonwealth, the soul was still something, something. One day, of course, the jig was up for me, you understand. So, imagine his surprise when I won in the ring right here on his home turf. You make an effort to imagine Falcon's surprise. Yeah, fine. So Ron didn't shed no tears about me getting thrown down. When I first met him face to face, he just says, "Oh, hey, Mr. Greentail." Like, he's just getting me or something. Though he did seem pretty miserable at losing me as a supplier. But he got me as a customer. Believe you me, his prices would be 10 times worse if not for Ricky Greentail's premier loyalty discount they can opt about. Just whatever you do, don't go around asking questions about him. The less we know about our group champ Pokemon, the better. Anyways, I'm off to chase myself a bit, so be seeing you around, sister. He bounced off out of the waiting. Though the now familiar surroundings of the Glade of Loom made preparations faster than before, the stars were already aflame by the time you and the others are gathered. Here we go, you ready, Faye? The great scribes created this celestial contest through which exactly such as ourselves may demonstrate our capacity for faithfulness and strength. We wish them all good fortune in time. It was said, and together we watch the celestial harmony in calm and silence, and await the pyre hearts. And for the Mephilonis, the outflow served each shock of it, weakness made the moment faster.
Limbless Erezek.
The much vaunted reader has returned, and it would appear her ranks grow stronger. Consorting with the bog-grown Birchrood, are we? How very strange that you befriended her. At any rate, your adversaries in this rite shall be the Pyre Hearts. Put out their flame and walk the path to liberty.
You can't stop us. You can take them. What's up for this one?
Ligaratus.
Hold a moment, leader. The common Bertrud status for pulling the remnants of the rites. Now that Bertrud is in our ranks, it would be best if you became familiar with her repertoire. You have no obligation to make use of her abilities, of course. With Bertrud, please show the reader something of your aptitude. We expect our child to be soon inclined to bring the sorceress to bear. Long have we studied these rites of thine. Let us show thee what we know of them thus far.
The bog crone Bertrud shows herself in full. Well, I have to wonder what became of her accomplices. Of one accomplice in particular. You watch yourself around her, reader. None are sentenced into exile without sufficient cause.
They won't be there anymore. Know that our freedom is of little consequence to us. We side with you because of Sandalwood, because of his plan. You shall all ID in the rites and you shall ID in that plan. Thus, we are at thy disposal and await thy bidding.
Who shall conduct the rites? Sir Gilman. Very well.
Tizo is fired up and ready to take on the Pyre Hearts. We're not afraid of you, especially not this time. We're knife attack.
Begin. The Nightwing's Pyre is the first to falter. Engulfed within the aura. Your pyre sputters. Sir Deluge, caught out. Tizo, douse them high. You have it! Your pyre weakens. Yes. In the name of Solium Myrrh. The Nightwings now are closer to achieving victory. An opportunity. We'll be right back. show of strength from the Nightwing's opponents. You left yourselves wide open. Fear not the purifying flame. By the scribes. Once more like that, and we are finished here. Now. No? That ought to wake you up. The two flames now burn equally as bright. Uh-huh. Banished from this place. Higher hearts banished to the last. And it is done. The Nightwings prevail. They hardly deserved it, though, if you ask me. The right is done.
Is this that? I know you have no chance. For shame.
Boundless are the teachings of the scribes. She now stands closer to the scribes, the little moon-touched girl.
I know, so because the scribes, they speak to me in this year, but I don't think it doesn't that I'm at all.
Until the stars align.
After triumphing over the Pie Hearts is none of victory, you return to the wagon to find Wolfred and the Lion Minister in the midst of conversation. Most strange. That this moon star should be eliminated now. This is not what I expected. No, I officer. Then Wolfred notices you there. Leader. Tarek and I observed a strange appearance in the sky, so it appears that the star of Chimera Rock Color is illuminated now. It is but another star, except our models and predictions of the cosmos did not anticipate this. Anyway, go see so for yourself. I shall make the wagon ready in the meantime. You see only a single shining star illuminated far above. It is just a full-fledged indicator. Do you got the moon star? And the rogue star. The rogue star burns bright over an isolated little island in the Sea of Souls. Lento is already on his way. Then we are summoned to the Isle of Chimera, deep within the Deathless Tempest. Have you been there before, Tarek? So long ago, Escaras recalled the time on descent. It is the place from where hence the creatures native to the Frostpunk world. Leader, let's not concern ourselves with superstitions held about that place. We'll set forth at dawn and soon see for ourselves what to make of it. You find two Zelda in the Blackwood on the Northern Mountain, the strong and the unusual. When you attempt to reach out to him, he barely notices you. Please indicate that he wishes to be left alone right now. You almost fall into fear as you can believe. I'm sorry, miss. I was just wanted to come to the middle desert there. I think maybe he's taken ill or something. On further inspection, it occurred to you that fair perhaps isn't off the mark, and that teaser is unwell for some reason. Oh, teaser, you're going to be alright. You might be the smallest one of us, but I think you're the toughest. Well, Mr. Darvish, she was the toughest one of all. Wait, wasn't she? I so miss her sometimes. Teaser appreciates the kind word, but still wishes to be left alone at this time. Oh, don't be silly, teaser. You know you'll be doing that, don't you? Faye turns to you from Luna, blowing her voice. Miss, I think this would like to have a bit of privacy if you don't mind. Though I don't want to be rude. It just is a will. I told him not to eat something that was this, so I think it was a mushroom maybe from the corner over there. So I see Tizel sniffing at it and he's always hugging, and usually I try to feed him, but this time I think no. Because I know my mushrooms and whatever that was, I think it was a mushroom. But it wasn't one I know, well, Tizel ate it anyway. Tizel corroborates his recollection of what happened. So, anyway, I think that he's going to maybe cover it up, I guess. I think maybe any moment now. Because when I ate things I thought were mushrooms around here, I covered them up as well. They made me with a seed, kind of like this over there. I hope that I'm not being inappropriate because it's not polite, maybe. Ah, come to think of it, Tizel, why don't we go outside? Because then I won't have to clean up after you. Like the last time when you ate something, I'd said maybe you shouldn't remember. Tizel indicates he remembers full well and regrets not eating his food where it comes in. Oh, don't worry, silly. If you've taken real, then I think you're going to be fine. Once you have a little walk outside with me, because you're very tough. Tizel is beginning to look better. Ooh. No, my best friend, Tizel. I won't let anything bad happen to you. Or at least, I'll try, okay? I don't think anyone could stop you from eating things, though. Then she snatches Tizel's up in her arms and whisks him out of the way from her. You hear her pull back to over her shoulder. Bye, miss. I'll make sure that this is right, I promise, okay? Although the prospect of fair and administering medical assistance only will give you pause, Tizel seems to accompany her willing enough. The two have shared a lot of close bonds since fair first made contact with the group. For someone like her, who has lived alone for so long, the friendship must be vital. And as for Tizel, he must be impressed that a non-native of the downside seems to know her way around food safety even better than him. That's it for today. Thank you. Bye bye.